Welcome to another video where we are going to talk about JSON. In this video, I'm going to explain what is JSON, what we are using it for, what are the data types inside of the JSON, and at the end of the video, we are even going to create some examples. So if that's something that interests you, make sure that you stick around. Before we write any examples, let's first talk about JSON. JSON, or JavaScript Object Notation, is data representation format. It's commonly used for APIs and config files. It is lightweight and easy to read and write, and integrates easily with most languages. So pretty much that's all that you need to remember about JSON. And now let's talk about JSON types. In order for us to be able to write properly JSON files, we first need to understand all the types that are supported by the JSON, and only then we will be able to create a valid file. So there are six different types that are pretty much basic and supported by the JSON. So first one are strings. So strings is anything between the quotes. So we can say like anything, hello, etc. You get the point. Numbers, it can be positive number, negative number, decimal number, etc. Booleans are true or false. It can be one of those two. Arrays, we define those by opening the bracket, left bracket, and closing with the right bracket. And then inside of this, we can have any of the valid JSON types. So string, numbers, booleans, additional arrays, and objects. So example would be hello, some number, then another array here, and then we can have the object, and I'm going to explain how to define object. Now object, we define those by opening left bracket and closing with the right, and then inside of object we are going to have key value pairs. So it needs to be like key and then some value here. So for example, we can say name, and then value will be, for example, Senaid. And then null is something that we use usually only for the value if we don't have something. And I'm going to explain that in the examples that we are going to cover. All right, so now that we know the basics about the JSON, let's now try to create some examples. So first, let's create one JSON. So we said we are going to create an object by opening and closing the bracelet. So if we do it like this, we immediately can see that this is going to be an object that is going to contain some data. So we can say, for example, students, and then that will be our key, and then value for this will be, let's say, an array. Okay, so now it means that we are going to have a JSON file that will be an object with key value pairs, where for the students, for this key, we are going to have an array. So let's say inside of this array, we are going to create multiple students. So let's say one of them will be, let's say, first name, and then we can say Senaid, and then maybe we can say age, we can say, so this is a number, then let's say is single, then this can be boolean, we can say false, and then address, we can say it's null, because let's say we don't know and don't have the information about that data, and then we can maybe say hobbies, and then we can have additional array, so we can say games, gym, etc. Now, since this is an array, we can have multiple students. So how we are going to do it? We just, after every object, need to say comma and then just create another one. So what we can do is just copy and paste this, and boom, it's valid again. And then we can maybe say just something opposite, So let's say 19 is single true. Maybe we have some address for him, and maybe for hobbies. Now it can be an empty array. We don't have it, but we know it's going to be an array. And since we said that JSON is pretty much a valid JavaScript, so now let's try to create one simple basic HTML page. So let's say index, okay. And then what I'm going to do from here, we can just say script, and then I will just say here, maybe const students equals, and now I will just paste, not this one, but entire file here, and that's it. So now, let me maybe zoom out a little bit. So now if we save this and go to the browser, of course there is nothing on the page, but if we check the console and try to say students, boom, now you can see that we are able to access this JSON here because it's everything inside of the variable, and we can nicely see it here. We can see that those students is an array with two elements. The first one is Senaid. We don't have address, we have age, first name, we have hobbies, which is array again, and have all the data here. And of course, there are second student and some details for him. Now, the interesting thing is that most of the time, what is going to happen is that this JSON format is going to be pretty much a text format. So in order for us to be able to see it in the way we just did, we will need to convert. So let me show you. So first, I'm going to put this as an string. Okay, and now let's check in the browser. So refresh, students. Boom, now you can see it's pretty much a string. So in order, if I want to see this as a proper JSON, this is what I need to do. I need to say JSON.parse students. And now we can see that this is not a string anymore, but instead this is a proper JSON that we can use. Now, the thing that you may ask is, is there a way for us to convert the valid JSON to the string? So let's see how to do it. So I will just clear this so it's back to the proper JSON again. Oops, students. Now it is again, but if I want to create it as a string, all I need to do is JSON.stringify and then boom, now we have a valid JSON format inside of the string or inside of the text format. And now this is something that you will deal a lot with different APIs, but because it's not always that they will return the valid JSON to you, but it will actually be in the text format and you will need to parse. All right, guys, I hope this was simple and easy to understand tutorial. If you want to see more like this, make sure that you subscribe. And also, if you have any tutorial requests or any questions, make sure that you ask in the comments below. Take care.